In this video lecture, for us mensuration 8, we'll be going to study about the instrumental method. This instrumental method is very important as compared to ocular estimate or non-instrumental method. So in the previous lecture, in for us mensuration 7, we studied about the non-instrumental methods. So where we studied how without an instrument, a forester can measure the height. So here we will measure by hypsometers, but on what the hypsometer is based on? So it is based on the geometrical principle of similar triangle. We'll study about that instrument. We'll also study about the instrument that is based on trigonometrical principles. Okay, now first we'll come to the instrumental method on geometrical principles of similar triangles. So as the instruments which are used in height measurement are called hypsometers, are called altimeters, are also called clinometers. But generally in many exams is to come in objective type that what are hypsometers. So hypsometers are the instruments for measuring the height, and also altimeter and clinometer both are also used for height measurement, but generally altimeter is for measuring the altitude and clinometer is the measuring the angle of that inclination. So what in hypsometer, altimeter and clinometer, these are being used for height measurement. So instruments are based, already I told you, either on geometric principles of similar triangles, this one, or they are based on the trigonometric principle of based on what base? That is the relation between the sides of right angle triangle. So that is the relation. We have here right angle triangle. You can see this is a right angle triangle. So these two triangles, these two sides of the right angle triangles, that's what's the relation. So there are a lot of trigonometric principles indirectly. We will be measuring that for the height. So let's come first with the geometric principles of similar triangles, which has been used by some instruments in measuring the height directly. But we have to be very clear, these things are for vertical trees. So very rare vertical trees are there, but when trees are vertical, we assume it vertical, and then we take the height by those hypsometer based on geometrical principles. Last lecture, in the previous lecture, we studied about a single pole method that is also based on a similar triangle, but we don't have and we don't consider any much of the calculations and other thing. A forester can direct have one pole, and on the taking one pole, he doesn't do much of the calculation and bothering that one. By simple measuring two angles, that I just last time I told you, one is the length from his eye length up to where he's holding, and one is same length from EC of the pole. He makes these two length of this triangle similar. So he makes the two length of the triangle similar. As it becomes similar, he moves to and fro and cover the entire tree with EC without his eye height. So here the eye height is not being considered here. He covers the entire AB with EC, and wherever it has been covered, he takes the horizontal distance from where he is standing, that is E to B, that is the height. So that is the easy method. But now we have to come to more accuracy. So we are now coming to the geometric principles, exactly the instruments which are based on that one. So we see here now, observer is standing here and he is holding one ribbon or a string with tied with some weight here like a pendulum, and then he is also trying to cover AD with the entire AD here, but here the eye height, you can see DB, BD is the eye height. This eye height will be added later on with the AD what he is getting now. Less better if you go in the field and understand about the practical, then we'll understand that how some instruments are based on the geometric principle of similar triangles by adding the eye height also. So that has been calibrated like that. Let's see the demonstration. In this demonstration, I'm going to explain about how these instruments like Christen's hypsometer, Smythies hypsometer and improvised calipers are based on. They are based on the principle of similar triangles. In the previous demonstration, I've shown you how to measure a tree height by a single pole method. Here it is a similar, but there's a bit difference. What we do, we take one plumb line. We can take one plumb line, and then we can suspend it at any known height, known length. At any known length, we will suspend it. So what we have to do, we have to make an angle by our eyes, and with this pen, and this is a horizontal line, I have made it, and this is a suspended plumb line, and some weight is there. So I will try to cover this entire length with the entire tree, from the top to the, not to the base, up to my eye height, because sometimes we cannot see the base of the tree clearly. Grasses and shrubs are there. I will go near the tree, and then I'll mark my eye length. What is my eye length? Oh, from my feet to my eye height. So somewhere I'm standing here at the base, and my height up to my eye somewhere here. So I have marked this one, my eye height. Which is 1.50 meter. So this 1.50 meter, I will add it after the calculation. Now let me measure the length of this ribbon where I have tied one metal to cover the entire tree with this one. It is not necessary that it should be the equal length of my, from where I'm holding to my eye. It can be of any length. So let me make of any length. Suppose it is here. And let me measure by the tape. Yeah, it is exactly 60.60 meter, or 60 centimeter we can say, from where I'm holding here. So this way I will make a triangle, and from the tip of this metal I will match the base of the eye height where I put that white color, and this tip of this pen where I'm holding the ribbon should be the tip of the tree. So I'll make a triangle. One triangle will be with my hand, the small triangle, and big triangle will be the imaginary, from where I will make a side from my eye to the tip of this ribbon where I'm holding at this pen to the tip of the tree. So let's see what is the height from where I'm holding. As usual, it should be 0.75. So it is 0.75 meter, or 75 centimeter. So this way I will go to and fro, and then I'll match and cover the entire this blue ribbon with the tree up to the eye height where I've marked, and that I will add later on. 1.50 I will add later on after the calculation. Yeah, I'm holding the ribbon, and that is the weight which has been tied on the ribbon. That white mark is there, that is the eye height. From there I will see without moving my head, only my eye, the top of the tree. I think I have to go a bit back, somewhere here. Again, the base is exactly here, and going on the tip with one step ahead, I have to come. Yeah, here, somewhere here I have to rest the suspended ribbon, and I have to see the height now. Yeah, exactly here. So this is a triangle made by my hand. Small triangle and the big triangle is the imaginary triangle, the tip of the tree. So I will see what is the distance where I'm standing. So this is the horizontal distance from where we'll measure base of the tree up to here. The horizontal distance from the base of the tree up to this mark is
29.40 meters.
So we have just seen the demonstration, how it has been done. We got some readings, as we got the reading of a ribbon that is from A to D. So A to D, we got the length of 0.60 meter or 60 centimeter, we can say. This is the length here. We are getting 0.60. Then we are getting the length from E to D, that is the arm. As usual, we got E to D, we got 0.75 centimeter. Or 0.75 meter or 75 centimeter. So, but now this observer has matched A to D with A to D with the tree, and then we got the horizontal distance from where the observer is standing from E to D, that is 20. That is, we are getting 29.40 meter. So this is what we are getting, the horizontal distance. Now we'll calculate by this formula. As we have seen this formula, we'll calculate by this formula, where AD, we can say, where AD is our 0.60 meter into the horizontal distance. We are getting how much? That is 29.40 meter, and divided by ED. ED is 0.75. So we get here 23.52. Now this is 23.52, the length from A to D, but we are not still added here the eye height. Eye height is 1.50. His eye height of observer is 1.50 meter. So we will add 1.50 meter, and then the total height A to B, we are getting how much? We are getting 25.02. So this is the height we are getting, more relative accurate as compared to shadow or as compared to the pole method. So this is based on the geometric principles of similar triangles, and already these instruments are based on that. One is Christen's hypsometer, another one is Smythies hypsometer, and another one is improvised caliper. So these are those hypsometers based on the similar triangles. So what is Christen hypsometer? So Christen hypsometer is, we can see, this is a 2.5 centimeter broad and around a 33 centimeter long. It is having two flanges here. So you can see two flanges here, one flange here, another one flange is here, and two holes are here. These are two holes, one hole in the lower side and one on the top side. These holes are for to tie a string. We can tie a string here, and then to hold it, to hold this Christen hypsometer to measure the height. So it is based on the similar geometric principle of similar triangle, and in the lower we will tie some weight so that it doesn't swing too much. So what observer will do here? Observer, see, this is I, from here is observing, holding this Christen hypsometer, and making just to and fro to match the, making the tree A to B coming inside this A to B, and these are the readings. So even we see the readings on the top, it is wider. We can see it is a wider scale is there. Slowly as we go down, it becomes very narrow. Now when we see from the from this side, we will try to make one staff. This is staff. Staff is of known pole or height we'll put on the base of the tree. Generally in India we use 4 meter. So we, our height will be in the meter if staff is in the meter. Okay, so what we will do, we will put DB staff there, and we'll try to see here the what is the staff reading at DB. So this top at small d and capital D will match it. So we will get the reading after we match this one. We will be getting AB is equal to, AB is the height, is equal to, we'll get BD into AB divided by BD. Very simple. This BD is this BD. We know this is 4 meter and this is AB. AB is this reading from here, and divided by BD, this one, we will get the height that has been already calibrated by Christen Hypsometer. So these are the simple things. And then we also have this Smythies Hypsometer, very simple. Any student, any researcher, anybody can make his own instrument called Smythies Hypsometer. Very simple. It has been made by a cardboard. You can put one graph paper, but it gives the reading up to 30 meter. Now, as also I want to come in the previous slide, telling that this is also a Christen Hypsometer, which gives the reading better up to 30, because above 30 you can see it is very difficult to read here, because you can see the scale is very narrow. So after 30 reading is very difficult, and it becomes very precise way to observe the reading. Similarly, this hypsometers we can't do in a very long trees. So let's come to this Smythies. So Smythies is very simple. You can see we can put one pendulum, add it one, we can make our own, and then we can hold it, and then you can see as we hold it we can see the reading, and then direct reading will come. There are two height here, base, and base is here. So this is just like a protector. But thing is, it shakes very much. So this is anybody can make and caliber this one. It is very easy. So you can see this is that plumb bob here, and this is height up to 30 meter we can take. This is the degree here. You can see the degrees are here, and this is the height directly we can get it from here. So this is Smythies Hypsometer, also based on the same geometrical principle. And then we have improvised caliper. Improvised caliper is, you can see this is a caliper. Here are we are some having some scale, and here also we are having some scale. So he will observe from here the height from A to B. So when he will put A to B, there is again a plumb line. This is again a plumb line. You can see this is a plumb line. Wherever it will come, it will cut this reading. You will get one reading that is called at M. So you will get reading at M. So M and whatever the reading you get it, you will put the reading here in this calculation when you take the height of tree AB. And BC is the horizontal distance. This is a BC is the horizontal distance where the observer is standing. Here is the observer. So here is the tree. This is the horizontal distance he is getting. And then we put the BC here, whatever it is, by 15 meter, 20 meter, 30 meter, or whatever it is. Then CP is the reading on this scale. On this lower scale, this is CP. So whatever reading we get on CP, we'll put it here. So this is improvised caliper. This is also based on geometric principle of similar triangles. So there are instruments based on geometric principle of similar triangles: Christen Hypsometer, Smythies Hypsometer, improvised calipers. So there are instruments, but these instruments have limitations. Like we cannot go for more height, or a tree should be a vertical one where we can also have a visibility on the base. Then this tree we can do on slopes, we can not do on windy types. So there are some disadvantages taking this hypsometers. We are having more better calibered one, better instruments based on trigonometrical principles. So in my coming lectures I'll be taking about the instruments based on trigonometry, and there are more better, more improved one as compared to this geometric principles of similar triangles. So thank you very much. In my coming video lectures, I'll be coming to the better instrument, how to take the height of a tree by trigonometrical principles also. And there are a lot of better instrument which gives more easy reading without much calculations. So thank you very much for watching this video lectures. Keep watching my upcoming lectures on false mensuration, lecture number 9. Thank you.